Hi, I'm Heather at the Kraaft Shaak, where we believe all were created by the Creator to be creative. Join me now for another art adventure. Hello and welcome to Heather's Art Adventure. Today I have for you an artist trading card as a part of the IlluminART Box challenge for the month of May. So I usually try to start with getting out the supplies and everything, and then the devotional, which every month it comes with a card just like this one that has the devotional in it. And so as I'm preparing to do this card, I read through the devotional, and "To Be Humble" is the title of this month's devotion. And, you know, the word has always brought me some confusion, I guess, because, you know, the meek shall inherit the earth. The Lord calls us to be humble and gentle, bearing one another in love. And these are all conjuring up in my mind's eye, a very quiet, shy, reserved, in the corner, wallflower type of personality. And if you know me, that isn't me. And I've always struggled with this because, Lord, I want to be your humble servant. But I ain't no meek and mild child. You know what I'm saying? So this one kind of struck me because I was like, well, I didn't know what to do. I started applying some watercolor because that's always, whenever I'm stuck with inspiration, that's where I go. And I just started adding color. And right away, you know, if you've been watching my videos, you know it's going to be bold color. I don't do soft, mild colors very well. I do big and bold. And right away, I'm kind of telling myself, you know, this isn't humble. This isn't humble, Heather. But I thought more and more about the scriptures that were presented to us for this. And Psalm 25, David's dilemma, where he's fighting against himself, his thoughts, and ultimately his shame, which maybe that's where I get confused. And then from there, we're taken to John 13, where Jesus he humbles himself to wash their feet. And their reaction is the same as mine would be. No, you shouldn't be doing that. That should be something I do for you. And that's when it hit me. That's when I started to realize some things. Number one, David wasn't quiet. He wasn't shy. He wasn't reserved. And he certainly wasn't a wallflower. He was a warrior. The disciples, once Jesus had risen from the grave, the disciples were immense, radical, shaking up their world guys. They weren't quiet and reserved. They weren't hiding in the shadows. They stood. They stood for something boldly, boldly. And that's when it hit me. You can be humbled. You can humble yourself. God is calling me to humble myself. Doesn't mean he's calling me to be wimpy. So that's kind of where it all started to change. And for me, with art, and especially, you know, the trends of the day and all those kinds of things, I'm not a face person. So this was another struggle for me, was that I don't really paint faces, and I do very little with faces. So when this is in the box, these collage papers from Dina Wakely, I was stumped by them. I really was. And in reading the scriptures for this devotion, and then looking at the supplies and everything, I was inspired once I had like this bright, bold colors on the left, that maybe on the right would be the face, and I could take one of these pieces and put them on there. But I was also worried that I wouldn't be able to color it very well. So that's why you see me putting color down and then lining it up with the picture, because I was thinking that I wouldn't be adding color on top of the collaged face once I got it on there. But again, this is just a journey. This is why we call these art adventures, because it really is an adventure trying to figure out what it is that we want to put down, especially when you have no idea where you're starting. And all the while thinking about the transformation in my mind about what the word humble really means and looks like, and from God's point of view, what it meant to be humbled from God to a baby to come and be on this earth, and then humbled himself in servanthood through his ministry and demonstrated for the disciples. This is why I came here, was to show you how to serve others, and then ultimately serving us on the cross. Just amazing. Just amazing. So I took this tissue paper that these are printed on and decided I didn't want that sharp edge there. So I got the tissue paper wet on both sides, and then using my thumbnail, I don't really have much of nails, but using my thumbnail to sort of pull the paper away where it was wet, and it gave a really nice soft edge, which allowed me to glue it on and have it just disappear into the card. Another part of the dilemma here is that it is watercolors that I've put down on this paper, and I don't believe it's a watercolor paper that they gave us this time. I don't think they gave us a watercolor card stock. It seems a lot more like it's a mixed media paper, which is cool. But then anything you get wet will just kind of wash off, as you saw me doing when I was smoothing out those right side colors. So we're going to try and put in some shadows where I know the eyes and the nose are, because again, remember, I'm telling you, I didn't know where I was going with all this, but I knew I wanted some of those colors to come through that tissue paper. And I thought if I laid down the color beneath it, it would give it a different look. It would look colored without putting color on top. Spoiler alert, I am going to put color on top eventually. But for now, let's just try this out. Just trying to soften the edges of some of that purple. And then I thought, ooh, I could add some texture maybe using the sea sponge. Yeah, not, it didn't really do much. But, you know, that's, again, all part of the adventure. So you see how much that watercolor just moves around. It moves around so easily that I knew if I put matte medium or something like that to glue it on, or even used glue for that matter, then I'd just be smearing around all that color. So I'm kind of in the back of my head going, how the heck are we going to do all of this? Now, overall, this entire piece took me about 40 minutes from start to finish. And that includes stopping and reading the scripture again, because I really wanted to make sure that I understood what I was thinking in my head. And it was so exciting, this transformation that took place from I always envisioned a wallflower to understanding that humble didn't mean wimpy. That it was just a transformation in my mind. I don't know. Maybe you already knew this. Maybe this doesn't sound like something all that newsworthy to you. It was, you know, for me, it was eye-opening. And in doing so, I was able to create something that I'm really, really proud of, because, well, I don't want to get too far ahead of myself. So I'm putting in those shadows right around the, I guess this would be the right nose eye area. And then, of course, around the cheekbone going back towards the ear. And that just gives the look of roundedness. These sketches that are by Dina Wakely on these tissue papers are really cool, and they come in multiple sizes. So you get like the same four, 4 images, I think, in large 8.5 by 11 sheets, and then 4 on a page, like I'm using in this ATC project. And then they also have them in like a white on tissue. It's white or gray. It's kind of cool. So there's black, there's the black markings and then sort of a white marking. So now I'm going to take some Liquitex matte medium and I'm putting it on the backside of the face. And then I'll be able to glue that right on to the ATC card. Now at this stage of the game, I really did think that I was getting away with just the color underneath. But and the idea then was that I didn't need to, you know, do any more, but I realized pretty quickly that that just wasn't going to be enough color. So I am going to go ahead over the top of the tissue and glue it down, being very careful not to put the glue on the left-hand side where that watercolor is, because I really want that to stay bold and bright. Because remember, what I've discovered is that humbling myself is about recognizing my own limitations. That's the word I'm trying to find. So, you know, pride and shame can be really powerful. I'm actually reading this from the devotional here. And you know, there's a lot of things about that that were making me kind of confused. But then once I realized this, you can still be bold in this. I'm having trouble putting it to words because it was just such an eye-opening moment for me. But yeah. A humble life requires a brave, deep, and honest look at life, motivation, and expectations, and is the same dilemma that faced David, the disciples, and you and I today as believers. So I read that from the devotional that came with this month's kit, and I think that sums up everything I've been trying to figure out. Like, it's faith and confidence, knowing who I have faith in gives me the ability to humble myself and serve others. I don't know. It was eye-opening. Well, I'd love to know in the comments below if any of this makes any sense to you, or if I'm just rambling like a crazy person. That's fine, too. But at this stage of the game, and I thought that I had removed this these drying clips, so I apologize that I left this drying clip in here, but we're getting this image finished up here. So one of the things about Dina Wakely's faces is that they're simple enough that you can improve them, or maybe improve is not the right word, but add to them so that they aren't just like stuck in one look. And for me, this image had no hair, so it was pretty easy to add hair. But for me, I was just thinking about being bold, being emblazoned with faith, and being able to be a shaker of the world around me. And I don't know why, but sassy short hair just seemed to be the thing this gal needed in order to demonstrate that properly. So that's what I gave her. I gave her a little bit of short, spunky hair. And basically using the Lyra, it's a water-soluble pencil that they gave us in the kit. And it is super cool to sketch with. I love these pencils so much. And that was really cool. And then I put a little bit of black watercolor on my brush and just sort of went in and dabbed here and there just to give it some more depth. So you can activate that pencil with water, but then it kind of softens up the color a little bit so it's not as bold. So that's why I went in with some black watercolor and just gave it some more bold marks, which, I mean, look at her. She's already standing out and popping forward, and I love it. I think this is looking so cool. So I took this Mark All pencil and I think it's a Stabilo All pencil and started putting in some highlights and opening up the whites of her eyes a little bit more and trying to give her just a little bit more life, because although this is a great starting point, I felt like there's just some stuff kind of missing a little bit. And a smile or a little smirk of some kind, I think, was necessary. So I did add that mark there and then made it a little too thick, but no worries. And then went to activate it, and yeah, it's just a little too much. So we'll dab that off the paper towel. And I did add a bottom lip because I kind of felt like it was more of a smile if she had a lip out a little bit. And you know, we all have that little dimple underneath our nose, so I was trying to add that there, but no, didn't work. So I removed it real quick. Which is really kind of cool part about this. If there's anything you don't like on top of this, you could pretty much wipe it off, because we did use the goodness gracious, what's that called? Liquitex Matte Medium, which created a non-porous surface. So you can just pretty much wipe it off, whatever you have left. Anything you want to remove is what I'm trying to say. So I added some pink, really bold, bold, bold opera pink. As bold as I possibly could, opera pink to that lip. And that's when I started to really feel like, yeah, this is an example of what it means to me. What I'm seeing now is that I can walk humbly, but still be the bold, fearless person I think that God created me to be. So it was kind of exciting. Adding a few highlights with the India ink, Bombay India ink, just, that's a really neat thing to add to your arsenal of mixed media stuff if you want, because you can add white to anything easily. I put some white on the bridge of her nose thinking I was making a highlight, and then I had a little bit of black on my finger when I went to smear it, and that created another line, which as it turns out actually doesn't look too bad. Add a few more shadows. Real loose, trying not to put in too much. Definitely don't want to give the impression that there's too much going on. A little bit of pink added to the whites of the eye there kind of makes it look a little bit more lifelike. And this is a watercolor pencil by Derwent that was included in the kit as well. Rose Matter Lake is the color. And then I used Jade Green to make those eyes because, I mean, duh. So the only thing that I can think of at this point is maybe some words. Just giving it a good look over. And yeah, I think we'll put on there, stay humble. And then as I was looking at this, I realized, you know what? There's one thing missing, a little bit of gold. So I'm going to protect the face with a sticky note and get my gold watercolors out. Sprinkle a little bit of gold on that left-hand side. And that's pretty much going to do it. So if you're wondering how you can get your hands on an IlluminART box and be a part of the ATC challenge they do every month, all the details are listed in the description of this video. There's also a blog post that can explain how you can get on the list if they're sold out. And I would love to see you join and be a part of this. It's so much fun to get supplies sent in the mail, to have inspiration, and to have it all be Christian-based with a devotion and everything else. Is just really a lot of fun. I'd love to share this with you. So please consider joining, being a part of the IlluminART Box. Again, those links are down in the description, as well as a blog post. And I'd love it if you left me a comment about what you thought about this. Thanks so much for watching. Stay to the end so you can see all of these awesome close-up pictures. Have a crafty day, everyone. Bye-bye.